Okay, this is a video to perhaps help someone who is handicapped and don't know what their capabilities are. So I'll do my best to show you what I can do. Making a base for a cross. Miter saw. Now we're going to lay out the block that I cut is for the base of the cross I'm going to make later, but right now we're going to lay out the base. Simple as put it in a vise. Don't move around. I'm trying to rush and that's not a good idea. Take your time. Find the center. Oh, I just cut it 6 inches. All right, maybe 3 inches. The center. One cross right in the middle, one hole right in the middle, so go corner to corner. By 16ths in the center. The drilling's done. The base is done. Pepper. Finishing touches. Now we're going to make the cross. The cross will be 6 inches long. 6 inches high, wherever you want to put it, the upper right. Okay, we've got 6 inches marked. Now we need the coping saw. Cut off that 6 inches. Here comes the coal, bro. Okay, now the vertical. Half of that, so it's 3 inches. I tell you not to use it for a hammer. I use it all the time for a hammer. Of course, sometimes it breaks. Half of it is 6 inches. That's 3, so half is 1.5 inches of center. And file. This is a hobby. I make crosses for the church where I going down in Connecticut. This film is being made in Maine, the place where my grandson stays. And that's my grandson doing the filming. Red, what I call him. I'm sure his name will be on the credits. If it's not, I'll give him the devil for that. Cross I measure the upright is 3.5 inches. No, 6 inches for the big one. I'm sorry. I make one for the church. It's 1/4 inch dowel stick. This is 5/16, and it's special.
We're recording again.
Okay. Joint. Put it back in the vise. That's 3 inches. You know that. So now we find the center, which is 1.5 inches. And then we take a file. And we're going to file a notch. Take a while. This is, of course, a file. I usually use a bass file. This is a 00. Well, anyway, that's what we do. We file that down. in there. Now we put this back in. And you file the same notch for the upright, for the cross, vertical bar, like that. Okay, and then you put the two together with glue, and you have a cross. The file's too fine, so we're using a coping saw. It's working, I hope. About halfway. Okay, I'll do the same with the vertical piece. That's the horizontal, here's the vertical. Put that back in. Saw down about halfway. Never done this before. I don't even want to do it again either. Looks about halfway. Now, it works and we'll go together. There you have it. About 5 minutes. My favorite thing, making crosses for the Lord. I make it for my church. I've probably made close to 1,000 over the years. I love doing it. I love the Lord. And you should too.
Help her with things again. Coming down to come this weekend, so I'm going all the way home and coming back again. They want us to stay there, and then Brian and Mark are doing her having that blade.
Well, I'm trying to rig.
Yeah.